If there is a theme that connects the dots in the Middle East, it is that chaos breeds terrorism. What much of the foreign policy elite fail to grasp, though, is that intervention to topple secular dictators has been the prime source of the chaos. Intervention when both choices are bad is a mistake. Intervention when both sides are evil is a mistake. Intervention that destabilizes the Middle East is a mistake. So yes, we must now defend ourselves from these barbarous jihadists. But let's not compound the problem by arming feckless rebels in Syria who seem to be merely a pit stop for weapons that are really on their way to ISIS. Intervention is not always the answer and often leads to unintended consequences. But some will argue, no, it's not intervention that led to this chaos. We didn't have enough intervention. They say if we had only given the rebels more arms, ISIS wouldn't be as strong now. The only problem is the facts argue otherwise. They say the definition of insanity is doing the same thing over and over again, expecting a different result. We gave 600 tons of weapons to the rebels, and they got weaker and weaker, and ISIS grew stronger. Perhaps by throwing all of these weapons into the civil war, we actually degraded Assad's ability to counter them. One of the men with the most knowledge on the ground of this, who's been our ambassador to Iraq and Syria, says, we don't have a clue who the moderates are and who the jihadists are. And even if they tell you they are the moderates, oh, we love Thomas Jefferson. Give us a shoulder-fired missile. We love Thomas Jefferson. Can you trust these people? Listen carefully. Your representatives are sending $500 million to people who will tactically ally with al-Qaeda. So we asked them, I asked Secretary Kerry, I said, where do you get the authority to wage this war? And he says, from 2001. Some of the people fighting weren't born in 2001. Many of the people who voted in 2001 are no longer living. We voted to go to war in Afghanistan, and I supported going into that war because we were attacked and we had to do something about it. But the thing is, that vote had nothing to do with this. Absolutely nothing to do with this. You are a dishonest person if you say otherwise. That sounds pretty mean-spirited. Hear it again. You are intellectually dishonest if you argue that something passed in 2001 to do with the people who attacked us on 9/11 has anything to do with sending arms into Syria. The moderate rebels are fighting with al-Qaeda. We could use the 2001 use of authorization of force, as Secretary Kerry understands it, we could use that authorization of force to attack the same people we're giving the weapons to. Think about the insanity of this. There are valid reasons for war. They should be few and far between. They should be very importantly debated, not shuffled into a 2,000-page bill and shuffled under the rug. When we go to war, it's the most important vote that any senator will ever take. Many on the other side have been better on this issue. When there was a Republican in office, there were loud voices on the other side. I see an empty chamber. I'm not sending any American soldiers. I'm not sending your son, your daughter, or mine over to the middle of that chaos. The people who live there need to stand up and fight. Civilized Islam needs to say to radical Islam, this does not represent our religion, that the beheading of civilians, that rape and killing women does not represent Islam. The voices aren't loud enough.